Hi, this is Gillian with another episode of Video Marketing Easy Peasy, because marketing your small business with video should be easy peasy. Today I'm going to walk you through a program called Veed.io, and I like this program because it does a lot of things all in one neat little package. So let's go ahead and jump right in. So Veed.io here, I'm going to go ahead and log in. And you'll notice that they work with a magic link. So now I have to zip over to my email and grab the link, which I'll do right here. Okay, so we have the magic link now. So I'll just go ahead and click that and we can log in. So let's start a new project from scratch. So I'm going to click Create New Project. And then we go ahead and upload my video. And my video is right here on my desktop. And I put a little folder together and here's my video. So I'll go ahead and open that up. And there's my video. And so this is what I wanna walk you through so that you can kind of see exactly how Veed works. So Veed is kind of neat in that it allows you to do your editing. It allows you to do your subtitles and allows you to do polishing, which means if you have a 16:9 video, you can actually make it one of those kind of social media square videos with sort of a top and a bottom empty and have your subtitles on the bottom and your head have a headline at the top. So it allows you to do all that kind of fancy stuff. So let me walk you through first through the editor. So if you want to just trim the beginning or end, you can just click here and you can just drag it and you can change how it starts. And you can do that at the beginning and you can do that at the end. So if you kind of get those situations where you're like turning on the camera and then you're kind of sitting back, you can just trim that right out. That's easy. But what I like about Veed is that it allows me to go through.
Hi, I'm Gillian Whitney with Launch for Life.
So if I wanted to cut out that whole beginning there, I can do what's called a split. Click that where it says split. And now this section here, I can delete that and it's gone. So now we just jump right into this video. So
now, checking out my LinkedIn profile.
So I think that's kind of cool. And if it's like, I want to kind of put a little bit of back, I can go back and fiddle with it. But I like the split that allows me to like cut out segments in the middle. So if I came along here and here's the timeline, if I moved it here, and of course I would be listening to the video, of course, but if I decide, oh, I want to make a split here and then I'm listening, and then I want to make another split here. So basically you look at this and you see that here is the beginning. Here's this pit that I want to throw out, and there's the beginning. So you can do some really cool, easy peasy editing. What's nice is if you change your mind, there's an undo button. So I can sit here and I can undo and get all the way back to where it was before. So I think that's kind of neat that it has all that forgiveness as well. So that's how the editing works. Easy peasy. I like that. You can even add an additional video clip. So if you had one little clip you did and then you have another video clip and you want to add that in, you can do that as well by just clicking on the add button. So easy peasy editor. So the next bit, what about if I want to do subtitles? Well, this allows you to do subtitles as well. So if I go ahead and I click on subtitles, I have the option of uploading a SRT file. So if I did my subtitle somewhere else, I can do that. But I like this because I can do it all in one step. So I've made my recording, either I did something in Loom and then I download it to my computer and I uploaded it into Veed. Maybe I just went ahead and used my camera on my cell phone. Maybe I just went ahead and used the photo booth app on my computer and I just uploaded it. So it doesn't really care where you bring the video in from. It is doing all this extra stuff together. So if I wanted to do subtitles, all I need to do is come over here. And like I said, if I've got my subtitles somewhere else and I have an SRT file, I can go ahead and upload it. But if I want, it can actually do that for me. So all I need to do is click on Auto Subtitles. I can then come down here and choose what language do I want. So I just want English, United States. And then I click Start. And what it does is it takes a couple minutes to go through, and it's analyzing the entire video, and it's going to walk through and put those for me. So that's pretty quick. So you go through here, and it starts with, thanks for checking out my LinkedIn profile. And I can play this.
If you'd be interested in...
I can play this and go along with it bit by bit and listen, or I can just review. And anything that I want to change, like for instance, thanks for checking out my LinkedIn profile. Well, that's fine. I enjoy helping coaches, consultants, and business owners be more visible with easy peasy marketing solutions. I'm also a bit of a Google artist, which means that I know blah, 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 blah. I can go through here. If there's anything that I want to change, probably not eating you on LinkedIn, I would be meeting you on LinkedIn. So let's go ahead and change that. And there we go. So I'm just going to leave it at that. In the interest of time, I'm not going to fiddle with all the different things. But as you can see, I literally just go in here and make any edits that I want. So I look at this and I say, okay, do I like how this looks? I can change the style. So I can have a basic color. I can have it outlined. I can have it, block and block or one single block. I can go through and choose whichever way I think is good. So I'm going to go ahead and just pick that for now. And then I would go up here and I can change the font style. I can change the font size. I can change the color. So maybe I want to make it white, make it purple, make it yellow. I can do whatever I want. So I'll just make it orange for now. And we'll come back and play with this. And oops, clicked out of that. And that was in styles. And then here I can change. Do I want it to be a different font? On and on and on. I can go making all sorts of different changes. I can make it centered. I can make it to the left. I can make it to the right. I can do all sorts of different things. So another thing I wanted to show you is how I can change this. Right now, this is a 16:9 aspect ratio. So think YouTube, it's a rectangle video. So what if I wanted to make this a LinkedIn video and I wanted to make it square? All I would have to do is go up here where it says settings, and then I would, it's by default, just bringing in whatever it was. But if I say, I want to change it to a square video, I would just choose 1:1. And so now all of a sudden it has taken my video. It's put it in the middle. I can move these subtitles up. I can move them down, and I can actually choose a background color. So say for instance, I want it to be blue, orange, pink, red, blue, whatever color I want it to be. So I'm going to just go with this sort of purpley blue here, but I can choose whatever color I want. And now if I want, I can even add a headline at the top. So what I would do is come over here where it says text, and then I can choose headline title. And here's my headline. So I can put that up here, and I can just put whatever I want it to be. I just go over here and write in the text. So it could just be Gillian chatting. I don't know. That sounds good. And then I can change it to whatever font size I want. I can make it bigger. So maybe take it up to 60. How about I take it up to about 72, and I can stretch it out. Look at that. I can stretch it out all the way, put it wherever I want. I can put it in the center, to the sides, make it bold, change the font type. And I can again change the color. So here we go. I could make this I don't know. We'll go with yellow. Why don't we go with yellow and see how that works? So then if I look back at this and say, oh, well, if that's yellow, I don't want this to be orange. All I have to do is come back in here. And now I could change that to be white. So you can come and play with this as much as you want. Make it bold, not make it bold. Do whatever you want it to do. So that's kind of fun as well. And at this point, if I wanted to say, maybe bring in my logo. Let's go ahead and do that. So I'd come over here where it says upload, and I can upload an image. So I'll go ahead and bring in my logo, and let's see how that does. So there's my logo. So maybe I want to put my logo over here, and let's pull it down at the side. So there we go. We got my logo there. So I've got my logo. And I can put my logo here. I can put it wherever I want. I really like the ability to be able to drag and put this wherever I want on the screen. That is intuitive for me, an intuitive editor. So what if I want to put some other kind of graphic? So I can go over, and I love Bitmos. So I'm going to grab this little Bitmo. And so now I have her. So let's make her smaller. And maybe I'll put her up here. So I can do that. Make her a little bit smaller. And there she is. She's up here. And I could decide, you know what, I want my logo up there too. So I can move anything wherever I want. I can put her back down on the screen. And then I can just have my title up at the top. And there we go.
Thanks. And I.
So the interesting thing is, because I was towards the end of the video, if I move, this is sort of the timeline bar, we see, oh no, I've lost all these graphics. Well, that's not a big deal. All I have to do is drag them back all the way to the beginning, and now they go for the entire length. There's that girl, the little Bitmo. So we see that's the whole length. I just have to do the same for these. So that's kind of easy peasy. Of course, can't do it while I'm showing you. So click on it. Now we have the double edge. Bring it all the way to the end. And then let's do the same thing. Click once. Now we see that double edge. Bring it all the way to the end. And there we go. So now if I move this sort of timeline along, we see that we have our captions all the way, we have our image all the way, we have our logo all the way, and we have our headline all the way. Okay, so at this point we could be done, but I'm going to show you one more little thing that I think is kind of cool. It has, under elements, you can add in a progress bar to kind of see how much time is left. And you know, you can add emojis and shapes and waveforms and all sorts of cool things. But I'm going to just show you how you would add a progress bar to kind of see, well, how much time is left in this video. Gives your viewers a little bit of a feel good of how much is left. So if I go ahead and I click that, then I can decide, do I want it on the video? Maybe I want it on the video. Maybe I want it in the purple area and move things down. Maybe I want it down here at the very bottom and I'll move these up a little bit. So maybe that's a good idea. You can decide where you want it to go. And I just want to pull it. Let's put it here and let's pull it to the length of my video. So there we go. And I might say, well, you know, gray and white's kind of boring. What can I do better than that? So I might say, okay, so how about we make it black and maybe we make it orange, or maybe we make it red, or we make it blue or yellow or whatever we want it to be. So maybe we just want to match it with this gold up here. Doesn't matter. You can choose whatever you want it to be. So now when we play the video, watch how it plays. See, it just kind of gives you an idea of how long have we got until this video gets to the very, very end. It's filling up, filling up, filling up, and it's done. So anyways, kind of cool. So at the very end, if you're happy with all of that, of course, you can keep adding all sorts of other stuff, and you could be here all day adding stuff to this video. And it is saving every single time you do something. It is saving anytime you want to go back. You can just hit the undo. You can hit redo, whatever. So probably a good idea to give it a name. So I'm going to call it Gillian Chatting. And that way we don't have a bunch of projects called Untitled. And you see, anytime you do something, you just get that little save notice up at the top. So at this point, if I'm done, all I have to do is come over here, click export. And you'll see how quick it is. So it just goes through, it renders my video. It's rendering my video in HD quality for me. And I just have to be patient as it's going to take a couple minutes to do that. And ta-da, it is done. It is done. So it just shows me, here is my video. It's good to go. So at this point, if I want to download it, all I have to do is go here, click on download, and there it is. It's downloading to my computer. So let's go ahead and pull that out and let's have a look.
Checking out my LinkedIn profile. I enjoy helping coaches, consultants, and business owners.
So at that point, I am ready to upload my video to LinkedIn. The only thing missing is probably a thumbnail, and that's a whole other video. So we'll do that another time. but that gives you an idea of what's involved with using Veed.io. I really think this is a cool tool. They do have a free program, so you can go in and check it out. It limits how long you can do a video, and it's going to put a watermark up here in the upper left-hand corner that says Veed.io. So that is kind of what happens if you use a free plan. But I think it's a very affordable plan. I love the fact that it's got the editing built in, the captions built in, the ability for me to take it from a 16:9 and make it a 1:1 ratio so that I can have my headline and my captions underneath my video. So I think it just does a lot of cool things all in one. So I suggest you give it a try. If you enjoyed this episode of Video Marketing Easy Peasy, please give us a thumbs up and leave us a comment below. And that way, if you have any questions, we'll address those and get back with you. Thanks a bunch.